Hey everyone, welcome to Cricut Time. If you like this video, subscribe for more project ideas and tutorials on all things Cricut. Hey everyone, have you tried making one of these fun doormats yet? If not, I'm not going to sugarcoat it. They are actually kind of hard to do. But today I'm going to give you these 5 top tips on how to make it easier. Number 5, for your materials. Get your blank mat from IKEA. They're only $4 for the 16 by 24 inch size, and use black flex seal spray. It's so easy to use, it only takes an hour to dry, and it won't slide under the design like a brush will. Use 2 coats and wait for them both to dry completely before you take off your stencil. Number 4, use a 24 inch green mat. It just makes life easier if you're using the right size for the job. If you don't have a 24 inch mat, slice your design in half in design space, and then carefully line them back up on your mat. Remember, if there's even a tiny gap between the 2 pieces, the flex seal will get in there and you'll be able to see it once you're done. So if you have any gaps, just put some tape there so the flex seal can't get through. Number 3, use tape to line up your design before you take the backing off the vinyl. You don't want to lift it and reposition the vinyl very much because the little fibers of the mat will get stuck to your vinyl every time you do. If you have your design mapped out before you take off the backing, you don't have to do any of the guesswork about how to line it up once you're ready to stick it on. Number 2, if you have any writing or small details, use transfer paper to keep them in place, but only use a really thin piece. When you go to remove the transfer tape, it kind of pulls the whole design because the fibers of the mat move. Because the mat is already so hard to stick things to, you can run into a lot of problems removing the transfer paper while keeping your design in place. If you only use a thin piece of transfer paper, you can still keep your design together without pulling too much on the whole design. Number 1, the hardest part of this project is getting your stencil to actually stick to the mat. You can use something rigid like cardboard, but you're going to have a lot of bleeding around the edges. Ironing on freezer paper works, but it's hard to get it into place. Stencil paper is easy to position, but it doesn't stay stuck to the mat very good and it's super frustrating to line up. I recommend saving yourself the hassle and just going for permanent vinyl right from the start. These go on sale all the time at the discount bin at Michael's, so next time you're in, just grab a roll and your project will be way less stressful. Once you're happy with the placement and you've stuck down your vinyl, use pins to make sure that everything stays in place. For the little pieces like the triangle inside an A for example, line it up how you like it, and then stick in a sewing pin. Once you spray your first coat of flex seal, the edges and the little pieces will curl up a bit. If they are pinned down, they're easy to just push back down in the exact same place when you go to spray the second coat. Once all of your vinyl is stuck down, cover the rest of the mat with newspaper and tape it down. This will keep your spray only where you want it to be. Well, thanks for watching today, and I hope this video helps you on your next doormat. If you liked this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more project ideas and tutorials on all things Cricut.